Yeah, good morning, all of you. And in this class, we are going to discuss in detail about the insect integument. Insect integument is nothing but the skin of the insect. Insect integument is also called as a body wall of the insect. You know, that the most important structural character which is responsible for the success of the insect or dominance of the insect is the insect integument. In our case, in the human beings, we have the skeleton inside. We have the skeleton inside, which is nothing but bone structure, which is responsible for giving the shape of human body or animal body, and which is also responsible for keeping all the organs inside intact. And we have a skin as well. We have a skin which covers the entire body. In our case, similarly, we have a bone structure inside, skeleton, endoskeleton. But as far as the insects are concerned, it is called exoskeleton. It is called exoskeleton because it doesn't have bones. And in fact, the entire body wall or insect integument or the exoskeleton, whatever you call, will actually have two purposes. One works like a skin of our body and similar to the insect. And also it works like a skeleton because it gives away the shape to the insect and it attaches all the muscles inside and keeps all the internal organs intact. So that's the topic of the day. Because we understand that all the arthropods will have a chitinous exoskeleton, and most importantly, the class insecta. The exoskeleton is nothing but integument or body wall, which is very, very tough, which is really tough. And that is the reason all these insects are extremely successful on this earth. So in this class, we are going to try to understand about the structure of the body wall and what are all the layers present in the body wall and what are all the important chemical constituents present in the body wall layers, which helps actually for the survival of the insect. And also we discuss about the molting process, how the old skin is being removed and the new skin is formed at the time of molting. You know very well, especially as far as pterygota is concerned. In the pterygota, both exopterygota and also endopterygota, hemimetabolous and also holometabolous insects, the insects will undergo a kind of molting process. Even the apterygotes also will undergo a kind of molting process. As far as the apterygota, ametabola is concerned, even the adult will undergo molting process. Whereas in case of pterygotes, adult will never undergo a molting process. But all the immatures like nymph in case of hemimetabola and the larva in case of holometabola will actually undergo a molting process so that the insect grows to the next level. So that the insect grows to the next level. So that is the beauty of the insects. That's the beauty of the insects. And that's how insects remove the old skin and formulate the new skin. And in this class, we are going to understand about the different layers of the exoskeleton. So let us see. Yeah. So this is the structure of the body wall or the integument. You can see when you cut the insect, so entire insect is surrounded with a kind of body wall, very tough body wall. And that tough body wall is also called as an integument. And look into the importance of this body wall. The body wall can be divided into 5 layers. Actually, there are 3 layers, but however, for our easy understanding sake, the body wall can be divided into 5 layers. That we will discuss in detail little later. Just to make an entry into the understanding of the insect integument and body wall, I wish to inform you that the body wall is actually a 5-layer structure. 5-layer structure. And as I told you that this acts as an exoskeleton, like a skin in humans, which covers the entire body of the insect, a kind of external armor, coverture, a kind of external armor, and which also support, like all the internal organs, including the muscles. That's how it works, like a bones in the humans. And because of this very tough exoskeleton, which is a chitinous exoskeleton, which gives the structure to the body and also form to the insect. The insect form is just because of this very tough exoskeleton. And in fact, it provides a lot of space to the muscle attachment inside. You can see the picture here in the below, that you will see the exoskeleton, which is covering the entire body parts. Once the new skin is formed, at the time of molting, the old skin is removed. And which also acts as a protective barrier, because I told you it contains number of chemical constituents inside. That's how it works, like a protective barrier. Not only because of the chemical constituents, and it also protects from the physical abrasions. And it is the one which is responsible for the conservation of the water, which never allows any water to get lost from the body. And also it will never allow any kind of pathogens or parasite or dangerous chemicals into the body. That's a wonderful. It's a very tough protective barrier, which do not allow the water to lose, which do not allow the pathogens, which do not allow the parasites, which do not allow any chemicals inside. There are different kinds of layers present in the cuticle structure. There are different kinds of layers that we are going to discuss in detail little later. But however, as I told you that it is a 5-layer structure, and especially the top 3 layers, and especially the top 1 layer, which is called as epicuticle, which contains many number of chemicals, many number of layers, which are responsible for the protection. And the exoskeleton or the integument also helps for the movement of the body. You know, that's very tough, and the muscles are attached inside, and that's how, because the cuticular structures, the joints where the wings and legs are attached, very tough, and that's how the muscles can move very easily. That's how the movement happens in case of wings and legs. And this integument is also modified into various sensory structures. That's how it's extremely important. And in fact, as I told you that it contains 5 layers, there's one very, very, very important living structure, living layer is called epidermis or hypodermis. It's a single cell layer. And those are the living cells. The entire body, well, as I told you, there are 5 layers. Out of these 5 layers, there's one layer, which is always a living layer, living cells. As I told you that the living layer of the entire integument is the epidermal cells. These epidermal cells secrete different kinds of chemicals and also different kinds of chemical constituents which are responsible for the production of the first layer, that's nothing but epicuticle, and also second and third layers. In addition to that, the epidermal cells also synthesize a kind of chemicals, attractive pheromones, a kind of pigments which are responsible for behavior modulation. You know the pheromones? These are the chemical constituents which are synthesized by the epidermal cells, which are responsible for the changes in the behavior of the other insects. And similarly, they also synthesize different kinds of chemicals which gives away color to the insect. And let us go into the details. Let us go into the details of these different layers. As I told you, though we always say that it contains 5 layers, but majorly there are 3, but however, we will discuss in detail about the other layers as well. So here you can see that the 3 most important layers are basement membrane. 3 most important layers are the basement membrane. That is the innermost layer, the bottommost layer. You can see here, this is the bottommost layer. That is the basement membrane, which actually is a base. And the next one is epidermis. I told you this is the only living part of the entire exoskeleton or the body wall or the integument of the insect. And the remaining entire part is called as a cuticle layer, but however, that we will discuss in detail little later. So basically, you can see there are 3 layers. One is the bottommost, very thin basement membrane. And in fact, to this basement membrane, all the muscles attaches. This is the outermost part of the body wall. This is the innermost part of the body wall. And remember, always, there are 3 important layers. One is the bottommost, very thin basement membrane, which is a non-living. And the second part is epidermal cells, single cell structure. And the third important part, outermost part, is the cuticle layer. That is the largest layer. That is the largest layer. So that is the largest layer. So let us go into the details. Let us go into the details. And this is the detailed structure of the insect integument. This is a very important to all of you to draw the structure nicely, neatly, and label it properly. Don't get confused. As I told you, that it is very easy to draw. Always remember, there are three major layers: the bottommost basement membrane, the bottommost basement membrane, which is a very thin, to which actually the muscles inside the insect attaches. And the second one is single cell structure layer, that's epidermis. Epidermis or hypodermis. And the most biggest and the largest part is the cuticle layer. But in fact, the cuticle layer is again can be divided into three layers. One is the endocuticle, exocuticle, epicuticle. So it means out of these, suppose this is the insect, this is the insect, this is the entire body wall. When you cut open, then it means there are five layers. The outermost is the bottommost, to which actually the muscles attaches. The bottommost layer is the basement membrane, then followed by the epidermal single layer, epidermal cells, then followed by the endocuticle, then followed by the exocuticle, then followed by the epicuticle. That's how easy to draw. The exocuticle and endocuticle, they're the largest layers. Together is called as a procuticle. So it means in the entire structure of the epidermis or in the entire structure of the exoskeleton or the integument, out of all these five layers, like basement membrane is very thin. Epidermal cells is a single cell structure. That's the only living structure. Then followed by the endocuticle, exocuticle, and epicuticle is very, very thin. And similarly, the basement is very, very thin. It means the topmost part and the bottommost part are very thin. The biggest part is the procuticle, which can be divided into exocuticle and endocuticle. So let us go into the details now to learn more about this integument. Let's see the first layer, that is the basement membrane, the low bottommost layer, the basement membrane. And this is the basal part of the insect integument at the body wall. And in fact, this is formed out of the degenerated cells, degenerated epidermal cells. It is formed from the degenerated epidermal cells. It means dead cells. It means it is non-living and shapeless, to which actually the muscles are attached inside the body. Very thin structure, maybe around 0.5 micron thickness. And now we will try to understand about the next one, is called epidermis or hypodermis, which is extremely important. I in fact always tell in every class, the biggest, busiest cells in the entire insect are the epidermal cells of the integument. They are big. They does every job. They are extremely busy in diluting the Wolkins. They are extremely busy in preparing the new chemicals. They are extremely busy in preparing the pheromones. They are extremely busy in preparing the pigments. They are the only cells. They synthesize, they produce all the chemicals which are responsible for the production of insect integument. Very important. It is a single layer structure. And the shape may vary. Remember, when they are busy, the shape the shape, the size goes so big. The nucleus size also goes so big. When they are not busy, when they doesn't have good, big work, then they are flattened. It depends. The size of the epidermal cells may go up and may go down, may be bigger sometimes, may be smaller sometimes. It depends upon the job it does. And they are modified. They are modified for various, I told you that they are responsible for production of all the chemicals in the epicuticle. They are responsible for the production of the chitin. They are responsible for the production of the protein. They are responsible for production of pheromones. They are responsible for production of some poisonous chemicals. They are responsible for the production of body pigments, what not. They are really the busiest cells in the entire body wall. And as I told you that the shape of the epidermal cells may change, the size of the epidermal cells may change based on the duty, based on the function they perform. These epidermal cells are modified into various glands. Glands means which produce some kind of chemicals. So, the dermal glands, dermal means skin, glands means cells which produce chemicals, simple. So they are modified as a dermal glands to secrete cement layer, wax, whatnot, all the chemicals required for the production of the topmost very thin epicuticle layer. They are also modified to become a sense cells, because these cells will give away, will go to the structures of the chitin outer growths wherein the sensory structures are located. And they are also modified as a peristigmatic glands in some dipteran larvae. So these peristigmatic glands will produce some kind of a chemical and gives away hydrofuse property so that water will not enter. So they have a different jobs. In fact, they're the busiest cells in the entire insect. They're the busiest cells. They produce everything. And then we will go to the cuticles layer, which can be divided, which is again divided into three layers: endocuticle, exocuticle, and epicuticle. All is epicuticle, exocuticle, endocuticle, epidermis. That's how you can remember. The bottommost is basal lamellar, basement membrane. Then the next one is epidermis. Next one is endocuticle. Next one is exocuticle. Next one is epicuticle. That's how you can remember. The cuticle is the outermost thick layer. It's a big layer actually. And it covers the whole body outside. And in fact, this cuticle layer is also present in the foregut and the hindgut and also in trachea, remember. And this is basically secreted by the, who is none other than the epidermal cells. They are the only living cells which produce everything. All the chemical constituents present in the cuticle, whether it is an endocuticle or exocuticle or epicuticle, everything synthesized and secreted by the epidermal cells. And this cuticle comprises around 50% of the dry body weight of the insects. That's what I told you, this can be divided into the topmost epicuticle, which is non-chitinous. Topmost epicuticle, which is non-chitinous, and innermost, the largest fast part, which is nothing but procuticle, wherein chitin and protein complex is present. So let us go and try to understand the different layers. The first one, the topmost, is epicuticle. I told you that the epicuticle is very, very thin, but in fact, very, very important. though it is very, very thin, but it contains four layers which are extremely important for the survival of the insect. They are very thin layers. That is the topmost part. That is the topmost part, very, very thin. That is the outermost part of the integument. As I told you, this is the outermost layer, the epicuticle, which is non-chitinous, which is extremely important. And that is the layer which actually prevents the water loss. That is the layer which prevents the abrasions, physical abrasions. That is the layer which prevents the entry of the pathogens. That is the layer which prevents the entry of the parasites. That is the layer which prevents the attack by the other outside chemicals. Very important, though it's very, very thin, but extremely important. And that also acts as a reservoir for metabolic wastes sometimes and defense secretions, everything. Let us go into different layers. Like, it is very, very thin, but it has got a four layers. The topmost cement layer, it means the moment you see the insect, you are seeing the cement layer. It means the moment you touch the insect, it means you are actually touching the cement layer. The topmost layer of the insect integument, which is nothing but epicuticle, and out of the epicuticle, the topmost layer is the cement layer. The moment you touch the insect, it means you are touching the skin. It means you are touching the cement layer of the insect integument. The next layer is the wax layer, and the next layer is the cuticle layer and the innermost epicuticle layer. So this is very important. So cement layer, wax layer, cuticle layer, inner epicuticle layer, all these layers containing many, many number of chemicals, all the layers containing many, many number of chemicals, and all these chemicals are secreted by the epidermal cells. And all these chemicals are secreted by the epidermal cells. Let us try to understand layer by layer. The first one is cement layer. I told you that the cement layer is actually secreted by the epidermal cells. Nothing but the dermal glands. Actually, these epidermal cells will have a dermal glands or dermal cells and modified epidermals, whatever it is. And this cement layer is composed of lipoproteins. And in fact, it protects the underlying wax layer from the abrasions. It also has mobile repair. Let us try to understand the next layer, wax layer. So this wax layer, wax means fats and fatty acids. This contains actually long chain hydrocarbons and esters of fatty acids and alcohols. Wax layer, the most important duty does by the wax layer is waterproofing. It will never allow any water to be lost from the body. That's the most important. And naturally, the wax layer is secreted by the epidermal cells. And the next one is cuticle layer. And this is very important. And the most important is it consists of some kind of proteins, polyphenols. And this is the layer which is responsible for the resistance to the acids and organic solvents. Cement layer protects the wax layer protects the insect from the water loss. Next layer is polyphenol or cuticle layer, which is response, which is actually resistance to the acids and organic solvents. And the last one is inner epicuticle layer. It consists of some kind of polymerized lipoproteins and stabilized quinones. And this actually serves as a reservoir for extracellular enzymes. So it means the outermost layer of the insect integument is the epicuticle. And the epicuticle contains four layers: cement layer, wax layer, cuticular layer and inner epicuticular layer. Though it is very, very thin, but every layer has a very, very important. Cement layer is very tough, which not only protects the insect from the abrasions, but also protects the physical abrasions to the wax, inner wax layer. Wax layer is extremely important because the wax layer is the one which protects the insect from the loss of water from the insect body. And the next one is cuticular layer, and the last one is inner epicuticular layer. So let us now go into the most large, biggest part of the integument is nothing but the procuticle. In the most thickest layer, procuticle is again divided into outer exocuticle, inner endocuticle. Very big layer. This contains chitin and protein. Remember, this contains chitin and protein. The most important chemical constituents of procuticle is the chitin. That is the characteristic feature of the insects. Always we refer insects contain chitinous exoskeleton. Insects contain chitinous exoskeleton. It means exoskeleton are the though it has high layers like epicuticle, exocuticle, endocuticle, epidermis, and basement membrane, the largest part is the content, that is the chief, most important chemical constituent. Of course, it contains proteins as well, but the chitin is the very, very important feature of the class insect. This layer also will have a protein, some kind of protein, but the important substance, chemical substance, is the chitin. And I told you that this procuticle can be divided into two layers, one the outermost exocuticle and the inner endocuticle. And this can be distinguished based on the darkness. Always remember, the exocuticle is very, very dark, whereas the endocuticle is colorless or untanned or uncolored. So exocuticle is colored, dark in color, and that's because of the tanning process. Whereas the endocuticle is not dark in color, is colorless, and it is because it doesn't undergo the tanning process. And outer exocuticle, it is hard, very dark in color. It is very hard because of the tanning process. And it contains rigid areas called sclerites, and that's how it contributes softness to the cuticle. Rigidity because it is sclerotized and tanned, dark color, very tough. That's how the entire exoskeleton, the entire integument is very tough. And that toughness, that hardness is because of the exocuticle. Inner endocuticle is untanned, soft, flexible, which contains proteins and chitin. And that is the largest section of the integument. And let us understand the chitin, because I told you the chitin is the characteristic feature. Chitin is the characteristic feature. And let us try to understand what is this chitin? What is this chitin? Chitin is a kind of nitrogenous polysaccharide. It's a kind of nitrogenous polysaccharide. And it is actually insoluble in water, alcohol, organic solvents. We don't go into the details of this chitin structure, but remember, it's a carbohydrate. It's a carbohydrate system, a nitrogenous polysaccharide. And remember, which accounts almost like 25 to 50% of the dry weight of the entire cuticle layers. And chitin is absent in epicuticle, that we know very well. And less in exocuticle and more in endocuticle. And the chitin is also is present in other animals as well. There are different kinds of proteins as well. Like most important proteins to understand are arginine resin. Arginine is present in the upper layers of the procuticle, which is nothing but exocuticle. And it is soft and water soluble, but insoluble and tough. It becomes very tough as a result of the tanning process. As phenols tans the arthropodin, and this tan part becomes very, very hard. That's how sclerates are formulated. Sclerates means plate-like structures. So that kind of tanning of arthropodin is called as a sclerotin, and that process is called sclerotization or tanning. And that is, arthropodin will undergo a tanning process, and that protein is present in the exocuticle. And the next one is resilin. I told you that endocuticle is very soft, flexible, untanned, not dark in color, light in color. And that kind of protein is present. It's a rubber-like elastic protein is present in the mobile joints. And that is very important in all the wing joints and the leg joints and all the mobile joints, because this protein is responsible for the flexibility of the body wall. So now we understand various important chemical constituents of different layers of the exoskeleton or the body wall or the integument. So in this class, we try to understand why it is important to understand about the body wall of an insect and the structure of the body wall of the insect. That's what, different layers in the body wall of the insect, and what kind of chemicals present because of which the insects are protected. The insects are getting protection. So that is the information for this class. And in the next class, we are going to have an understanding about various cuticular processes, and also we are going to see some small videos about how the molting happens. When the molting has to be performed, remember, all the old skin has to be diluted. Some of the chemical constituents of the old skin has to be diluted, and the new chemicals has to be formulated to form the new skin. So that we are going to discuss in the next class. Thank you very much.